Hi everyone, this is Sunny Kumar from IIT BHU and welcome to my channel Code with Sunny. And today I am going to discuss the very first problem of March EZ 2021 a bitwise pair. Okay, so let's jump directly into the problem statement without wasting our time. We have been given an array A of size n, and positive integers will be given, and we have to find the number of pairs of indices I, j such that this condition must be satisfied. You can see here I have a OR operator, bitwise OR and bitwise AND operator between the two array values. AI OR AJ minus AI AND AJ must be equal to AI minus AJ. So let's discuss the input format also. Test cases will be given first, then N size of the array, then the array elements. We have to print the number of pairs. We have to print the answer for each test case, the number of valid pairs. Let's look over the constraints also. Test cases varies up to 10, n is going to vary up to 10 power 5, so it is obvious that O of n square solution will not pass, and array values ranges up to 10 power 3, so there might be some advantage with the array values. So okay, so let's discuss the problem and analyze this. So we have been given an array of n elements, and we have to count the total number of valid indices ij such that ai zod aj equals ai minus aj. But you can see I have modified the LHS part of the condition as per question. So how I have derived this condition, so you have to be patient because I am going to discuss that also. So let's move further now. So what will be the advantage I am going to use in this problem? That is, array values ranges up to 10 power 3. That is, maximum value of the array can go up to 10 power 3. So if I am going to run a 2 for loop, each going to run up to 10 power 3, then this solution will pass, because the total number of iterations would be 10 power 6, which is valid under the given time constraints. Okay. So what will be the prerequisite to solve this problem? Greedy algorithms and knowledge of bits. Okay, so let's discuss the problem with the help of example and analyze this. Okay, so I have taken an array 4421, and here it is the condition. So let's first simplify the left hand side of the condition. Okay, so let's discuss that. Now you can see here I have taken four columns where these are the columns where I have the total number of possible k's for the bits, that is for two numbers. You can see 10011100, and here in this row you can see I have written something like this is the bitwise OR operation of the two numbers, where the two cases are like two possible bits 10. If we have 10, then it will come out to be 1. If we have 01, it will come out to be again 1 11, again 100, again 0. And this is the case where I have taken the bitwise AND operation for the two numbers. Okay, that is, you can see 10001, again 0, and 11, then I have got 1 and 000. Now if you subtract this according to the problem, bitwise OR minus bitwise AND, you would find that it is actually the ZOR operation of these two rows. That is, 1 ZOR 0 would be 1, 0 ZOR would be 1, and 1 ZOR 1 will be 0, because the bits are same. Again, this is 0. So this is actually the bitwise exclusive OR operation. If you subtract this bitwise AND row and bitwise OR row, that is, first we are going to subtract bitwise AND from the bitwise OR row. Okay, then you will find this one. Okay, which is actually the bitwise exclusive OR operation of the above two rows. So we have arrived to the conclusion that we have to actually perform the bitwise exclusive OR operation for the two array elements. And if it is equal to the A of I minus A of J, that is subtraction of these two array elements, then we can say our answer, that is, this is a valid pair. Okay. So how we are going to approach this problem? So if you have look over the constraints, that it is going to vary up to 10 power 3. So if we store the frequency of each array elements, then I am going to iterate up to 10 power 3 and check if there is a j such that I minus j is exactly equal to the i's or j, then I am going to increment my answer with the frequency of I and frequency of j. So this will be the basic approach to solve this problem. Okay, so let's move further. Now you can see, let's discuss the approach here written. We are going to create a frequency table to store the occurrences of the elements, run a nested loop each up to 10 power 3 because total number of iterations would be 10 power 6, which is valid, okay, in worst case, okay. So whenever we find I greater than j, check if the condition holds. That is why I'm going to check I greater than equal to j, because if I is less than equal to j, if I minus j would become negative, then this won't be any case, there won't be any valid pair anyhow, okay. Now if I'm going to check if the condition is going to hold or not, that is I's or j must be equal to I minus j, and if this exists, add the answer to the answer variable where current answer equals frequency of I into frequency of j. Okay, so this will be our basic approach, and the time complexity of this algorithm, or you can say this approach, would be O of m square, where m is what, 10 power 3 in worst case, and similarly space complexity would be O of m, because I am going to maintain a frequency array. Now you can, I am going to discuss the code. Okay, so here it is. Now you can see I have taken the first test cases. Now here it is n, the size of the array, and here I have maintained a frequency array whose size is 1001 for storing the frequencies of the array elements. Now I have traversed through the array and stored the frequency. Now I have iterated till up to 10 power 3. You can see I have a nested loop here that is going to give 10 power 6 iterations in worst case. Now if j is going to be greater than equal to I, I am going to break my this inner loop, because the value, that is I minus j, would become negative, so no need to iterate further. Now if I am going to check the condition, if I's or j is exactly equal to, that is if this is LHS part, I's or j will be exactly equal to I minus j, then our answer will be incremented by frequency of I into frequency of j. That is all possible indices that I am going to take out. Okay, so our answer will be incremented by this product. So finally, I'm going to print the answer. So let's submit this code directly and check out if this is going to be a good solution or what. Yes, all test cases are passed. So if you have any doubts, do not forget to mention in the comment section of the video. And I will ask the viewers to like this video, share this video, and do subscribe to my YouTube channel for latest updates. Thank you for watching this video.